Good day. God is on his throne today. Hope you're doing okay. Hope you're doing well. Just keep seeking the Lord. He is with you. He loves you. And just welcome to all of you from the Desert Hope family. And if you're listening outside of the Desert Hope family, nice to have you with me. We started John yesterday. We're going to continue with John. Now, John is the last written gospel. John, it's possible that John was the only disciple not to be martyred, if you don't count Judas, who hung himself. He was not probably martyred. He died in old age. The book is many times, most conservative scholars say between 85 and 95 AD. Jesus dies in about 30. Matthew, Mark, Luke were written about the 50s, right around the 50s, into the early 60s. And so Matthew, Mark, Luke are called the Synoptic Gospels, which means you see them together. They knew of, Matthew and Luke knew of each other when they wrote. And there was an understanding that they, at times, even used whole sections of other Gospels. So Matthew, Mark, and Luke are seen together. John, 93% of John is just found in John. That's how unique it is. It's written much later, you know, 40 years later, towards the end of John's life. And it is different. Like I said yesterday, there's no parables, although parables fill Jesus' teachings in the other Gospels. You got to remember that maybe John, in some ways, is trying to add some things that are not in Matthew, Mark, and Luke to supplement. And also because of he was fighting against some issues. And one was the church, apparently, very clearly, was beginning to lose its sense of divinity of Jesus Christ. So John makes it very strong about the divinity of Jesus Christ. And so this book is full of that, where it refers to Jesus or infers or says boldly that Jesus is God, but he's also man. That's made very clear also in John. Let's begin with the first line, first verse. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. So in the beginning was the Word. In the beginning, John wants us to think back to Genesis 1. My sermon a couple weeks ago, I talked about Genesis 1 being a almost liturgy. It's structured beautifully to show the consistency and dependability of God in the darkness and floodwaters. And God's Word was issued and it created life through light and through separating, so there's oxygen and air. And so Genesis 1 and John 1 are similar. John plays off of God's Word. Jesus is God's Word, John says. He's the greatest and the supreme communication of God to humankind. So Jesus speaks, is the Word God speaks to us as he's born a virgin and grows and dies and is crucified. And so in the beginning, John is saying there's darkness and chaos and floodwaters again before the Word of God comes on the scene. There is death because of our failure, our rebellion. We are separated from God. That's a great chaos, darkness, and floodwaters, which we find in the beginning of Genesis 1. But in Genesis 1, God's Word cuts through the darkness and brings light and life. Same thing spiritually with Jesus Christ. With the darkness of our sin and judgment comes the light, Jesus Christ, who is the Word of God, the new Word of God. And he speaks a message of hope. And so John is referring back to Genesis 1, and he is saying something about his whole book. This is a book about spiritual life and light. And Jesus is the life. I'm the way, the truth, and the life. And Jesus is the light. I'm the light of the world, he says. And so we have at the beginning kind of subtly telling us what the book is about. It's talking about the Word coming and bringing life like Genesis 1, but this time spiritual life. It's talking about the purpose of the book of John. Towards the end of the book, the second to the last chapter, John states what his purpose was. His purpose was that people might believe in Jesus, and by believing may find life in his name, everlasting life. That's the goal of the book. God, Jesus is the Word. And look for metaphors. Remember, John's the metaphor man, and he uses right off the bat a metaphor of the Word, a communication of God, which Jesus truly is. And Jesus is the Word of God. You and I have Jesus Christ. It's solid. It's dependable. The darkness is still there. As John goes on to say, there's still darkness, but light dominates and wins the day. But we, our darkness is expelled by the death and resurrection of Jesus Christ. In our beginning, God chose us. He predestined us. He called us his own, and he's saying that I love you. And so we're going to leave today with just with that note, that Jesus is our word. He penetrates into our spiritual darkness. Let's celebrate today the light that Christ has given us as the word of God. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your goodness and your love. You are so great, so good, so merciful and kind. I pray that you'd help us to know your love. Deepen our awareness of your love, our comprehension of your love, and may it transform our life and actions. Open up doors of service today also, and bless those who are listening who are struggling today with some issue or problem. Give them hope, God. Give them encouragement. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, let's glorify Jesus today.